Hi, I am Mr. Debabrata Nandi, Assistant Professor, Department of Remote Sensing, CIS North Asia University. Today, I discuss about fundamental of remote sensing. Definition of remote sensing: it is a science, art, and technology of acquiring information about the earth surface without actually being in contact with it. Means, remote sensing is a non-contact recording of information from the thermal, visible, infrared and microwave region of the electronic spectrum by means of instruments such as cameras, scanner, laser, linear array and area array located on platforms such as aircraft or spacecraft, and the analyze of acquired information by means of visual and digital image processing. What is remote sensing? Information is gathered by instrument carried on suitable platform. The information is usually study target of interest of on the earth surface. Platform is satellite, instrument is scanner, and the target is the land and water. Then three things are essential for remote sensing: one is sensor, another one is energy, that is link between the object and sensor. Then remote sensing means remote means far away, and sensing means recording. This is the stage of seven stage of remote sensing. First one is energy source or illumination. Second, recording radiation and the atmosphere. Third, interaction with the target for recording of energy by sensor, transmission, reception and processing, interpretation and analysis, and application. First, the energy source. This is the sun, is the energy source. Then energy interact with the atmosphere. Then energy interact with the target. Then emitted and reflected energy go to the sensor, or recording energy by sensor. Then transmission, reception and processing. Then interpretation and analysis. And last one is application of remote sensing. Then another example here, we take the aircraft for platform. The process is same, but instead of satellite here we use aircraft. Then next one, what is energy? Energy is the ability of doing work. Then energy transformed from one body to another or one place to another by three methods, that is conduction, convection and radiation. The energy transferred from sun to earth surface, that is called radiation process, and this energy called electromagnetic energy. Then electromagnetic energy or wave, they travel through space at the speed of light, that is the speed in 3 into 10 to the 8 meter per second. There are two types of method that can energy come from sun to earth surface. One is wave model of electromagnetic energy, and another one is particle wave of electromagnetic energy. This is the example of wave. This is wave, electromagnetic wave. And what is electromagnetic radiation? Electromagnetic radiation consists of an electrical field and magnetic field, and both of these fields travel at the speed of light, and the electric field and the magnetic field is perpendicular to each other. This is the example and animation of electromagnetic radiation, which here is the one is electric field, another one is magnetic field, and both are travel at the speed of light, that is 3 into 10 to the 8 meter per second. Here this is the wavelength lambda, frequency mu, and speed velocity of light c. There is a relationship, and there is a, or the equation is c is equal to lambda mu, mu is equal to c by lambda, and lambda is equal to c by mu. Here we see that mu is inversely proportional to wavelength. So frequency is inversely proportional to the wavelength. Now here, lower the frequency, longer the wavelength, and higher the frequency, shorter the wavelength. This is the standard unit of measurement of wavelength: kilometer, meter, centimeter, millimeter, micrometer, nanometer, angstrom, and this is the measurement of frequency, hertz, kilohertz, megahertz and gigahertz. So next one is, what is particle model? Light is a stream through a particle called photons of quanta. The relationship between frequency and quantum is called q equal to h nu, that where q is the energy of quantum measured in joules, j, h is Planck constant, that value of Planck's value is 6.626 × 10⁻³⁴ joule, and nu is the frequency of radiation. The particular following equation lambda is equal to c by mu multiplied by c by v with h into h by h, after dividing c by mu and h by h, the equation is lambda is equal to c by h nu. By substituting q is for h nu, then the equation lambda is equal to c by q, or q is equal to h c by lambda. Here we see that energy of a quantum is inversely proportional to the wavelength. Then what is electromagnetic spectrum? The distribution of continuum of all radiation energy can be plotted either a function of wavelength or frequency in a chart known as the electromagnetic spectrum. This is the example of electromagnetic spectrum. Here we use the prism and we get the visible light, electromagnetic spectrum of visible light. Then this is the another example of electromagnetic spectrum: gamma ray, X-ray, ultraviolet, infrared, visible, infrared, microwave and radio. This portion of the electromagnetic spectrum is called visible. The range of visible range is 0.4 to 0.7 micrometer. Then what is band? The particular region or band, particular region or interval of the light of electromagnetic spectrum is called band or channel. Human eye recognize only the visible portion of the electromagnetic spectrum, and sensor can recognize the another portion of the electromagnetic spectrum. This is the example. Here we see that the visible portion of human eye and the sensor, recognized portion of the sensor. Then Planck's law, it states that where the energy of the particle waves, and the Stefan-Boltzmann's law, this law states that the total energy emitted, U is equal to sigma is equal to epsilon to the power 4, sigma is equal to Stefan-Boltzmann's constant, and E is called epsilon emissivity factor, T is equal to absolute temperature in Kelvin scale. These are the parameters, type of wave and typical unit measure. Radio is called radio in meter, microwave in millimeter, infrared micrometer, visible nanometer and ultraviolet angstrom. Then the energy interact with the atmosphere. There are two way, one is absorption and another one is scattering. What is absorption? Due to the gas molecule present in the atmosphere, the EMR is passing through the atmosphere is absorbed strongly in the certain band of certain band is called absorption band. These bands are unsuitable for remote sensing. Then the spectral band for which the atmosphere is transparent are known as atmospheric window. These are the atmospheric window, that is infrared portion of ultraviolet and visible, that is range is 0.3 to 0.75, infrared that is 0.77 to 0.9 micrometer, 1.0 to 1.12 micrometer, 1.19 to 1.34 micrometer, middle infrared, thermal infrared, then microwave. This is the picture of electromagnetic portion which are come from sun to our surface by two atmospheric window, ultraviolet, visible and infrared. Then what is scattering? What is scattering? Scattering, atmospheric scattering is the called unpredictable or diffusion of radiation by particle in the atmosphere. It is called scattering. There are two types of scattering happening in atmosphere: roller scattering, mass scattering and non-selective scattering. Roller scattering, when happen, now roller scattering or molecular scattering is occurs when the effect of diameter, effective diameter of the matter many times smaller than the wavelength of the incident EMR. Then roller scattering is happen. The mild scattering occurs when the diameter of the particles approximately equal, that is 0.1 to 10 times to the wavelength of the incident EMR. The non-selective scattering, take place when the effective diameter of the matter is much greater than the 10 times wavelength of the incident EMR. These are the diagram of roller scattering. This is a gas molecule. Due to the gas molecule, roller scattering is happened. Then due to the smog and dust, the smog and dust diameter is same as the diameter of the wavelength when mild scattering happens. Then due to water droplet, non-selective scattering is happened. This is the example why the roller scattering is high in blue region, because in blue region the wavelength is smaller. So in smaller region, due to the low wavelength, the roller scattering is high in blue region. So sky looks blue. This is the example of roller scattering. Here sky. Then mild scattering. Due to mild scattering, the sky looks orange. And this is the non-selective scattering, but due to water droplet, the sky is look white. Then energy interact with atmosphere. Again, core fundamental energy interaction, that is reflection, scattering, absorption and refraction. This is the refraction. The incident energy come from optical medium to dense medium. Then the sign, according to Snell's law, bending of light from one medium to another, index fraction n is molecular order density, is the ratio of speed of light of a vacuum C to the speed of light in substance at its atmosphere, then Cn, n is equal to C by Cn. It measured by Snell's law, that is n1 sin theta 1 is equal to n2 sin theta 2. Then scattering is happened. The type of scattering depend on the relative size of wavelength, incident electromagnetic spectrum and the diameter of gas, vapor and molecule. Then absorption, the process of which energy, radiated energy is absorbed and converted into other form of energy. Then reflection, the process where a radiation bounce off from an object is called reflection. Consider the amount of incident radiant flux from the sun is reflected from top of the cloud and the other material in the atmosphere. The substantial amount of energy is radiated back to the space. Reflection depends on the reflector surface. There are four type of surface roughness. First one is ideal specular reflector, then near perfect specular reflector, near perfect diffuse reflector and Lambertian surface. In the first case, the 100% energy come to the sun is reflected, 100% energy is reflected. Here, the no scattering or reflector is take place. This is a hypothetical surface. Then second one is near perfect. Here, the 20% is reflected and 80% is scattered. Sorry. 80% here 80% is scattered and 10% is reflected, and in this portion all our energy are scattered. This is called Lambertian surface. Then energy interaction with the target. The amount of energy, radiate energy on, off or through the surface per unit time is called flux, that is called measuring what? Radiant energy are the return weight by reflection transmitted through material or observed and transmitted into some other form of energy of the other side of the terrain. The total amount of radiant flux in specific wavelength lambda, incident energy is equal to lambda I lambda, the amount of energy is equal to R lambda, then amount of energy observed by is alpha lambda and amount of energy transmitted to tau lambda. Then energy equation I lambda is equal to R lambda plus tau lambda plus alpha lambda. Percentage of reflectance P R lambda is equal to P R lambda is equal to R lambda divided by 5 I lambda into 100. This is the spectral reflectance response pattern of different feature. First one is vegetation. Then second, this is blue region, blue graph is water. So that water, and then this is the graph of mock soil. Here we take different stage of a leaf and we plot the spectral reflectance curve and see that the green look leaf or the healthy leaf reflectance is high and the stress leaf is reflectance low. The interaction with atmosphere again, energy matter interaction with atmosphere in once again that fourth fundamental energy into that is reflection, scattering, absorption, reflection. Then recording energy by sensor, this is the recording fourth stage where the energy recording by sensor. So some energy, some radiant energy other than the amount of radiant leaving LT, the terrain may enter into a field of view from various other parts like atmospheric transmittance, solar iridance, sky iridance, scattering, and introduce noise into remote sensing process. This is often called path radiance. The total path, the radiance recorded by sensor LS is equal to LT plus LP. Then transmission and processing. Here is the figure shows the transmission, reception and processing. Our India's transmission ground station is in the Sahatnagar. The interpretation and analysis, there are two types of interpretation and analysis. When first picture show the visual image interpretation, that is analog process, and in second picture show the digital image processing. Then what is sensor? A device that is respond to physical stimulation, heat, light, sound, pressure, motion, flow and so on, and produce a corresponding electrical signal, that is called sensor. There are two type of information give the sensor. First one is spatial information, second is spectral information and intensity information. We get through spectral information by spectrometer, where if we need spectral and intensity, then we use spectroradiometer, and if we only need intensity, then polarimeter, spectrometer, radiometer. Then this is the all type of sensor characteristics technology. There are classification of sensor. There are two type of, basically we divide the sensor, passive sensor and active sensor. And also passive sensor is divided into two type, non-scanning and scanning. And non-scanning also divided into non-imaging and imaging. Scanning also divided into imaging, image plane scanning and object plane scanning. All are classification of sensor. This is the active sensor. When we used flash, that is called active sensor, then without flash camera is called passive sensor. This is the best example of active sensor, where great found in his food at night. Then remote sensing sensor. This is the example passive and active. The sensor is device comparison of optical components or system and a detector array or detector at a focal plane with electronic circuit. This is passive sensor. Sensor that use natural source of energy. This is the example of passive, and this is the example of active sensor that use man-made source of energy, or that is called active sensor. Example radar and laser. Sensor can be non-imaging and imaging sensor. This is the different type imaging remote sensing. Framing system by frame, pixel by pixel with a wishbone, line by line with a wishbone. These are the method where we capture the Earth surface by remote sensing sensor. Then this is the SWAT. What is SWAT? Now sensor collects 2D image of surface in SWAT because of sensor. Example lens set has 185 km SWAT. This is the SWAT of sensor. then resolution. Resolution is defined as the measure probability of an optical system to distinguish between signal that are spatially nearer, near and spectrally similar. All remote sensing systems have four type of resolution: spatial resolution, spectral resolution, temporal resolution and radiometric resolution. What is spatial resolution? A spatial resolution is a measure of smallest angular of linear separation between two objects that can be resolved by sensor. That is called spatial resolution. Then spectral resolution. Spectral resolution describes the ability of sensor to define fine wavelength interval. The finer the spectral resolution, the narrower the wavelength range for a particular channel or band. Then temporal resolution, frequency at which image are recorded or captured at a specific place on earth. More frequently it captures, the better of the finer of temporal resolution is said to be. For example, a sensor that captures an image at a agriculture land twice a day has better temporal resolution than a sensor that only captures the same image once a week. This is the temporal resolution. Then radiometric resolution, it is defined the ability of sensor to detect the number of various electromagnetic signal or how many grayscale it can identify. This is 2 bit and 6 bit image, 8 bit and 10 bit, that is the different bit of radiometric resolution. Then what is platform? The typical platform are aircraft and satellites. The selection of platform depends on the purpose of altitude. The atmospheric condition is defined depending on the altitude. This factor must be considered the selection of platform of a sensor. These are the different type of platform we used according to the altitude. These are the example of, this is the ground-based platform, this is the ground-based platform, this is the space-based platform and this is the air-based platform. There is the there are different type of platform, altitude and observation we are used. Platforms of ground truth, which we used in ground-based platform, the altitude of ground truth is 0 to 30 meter and can crane car, this is the altitude is 5 to 50 meter, cable 0 to 40 meter, balloon 100 to 100 kilometer, low flying aircraft 500 to 800 meter. This is used for aero survey, high altitude plane, this is 10 to 12 kilometer reconnaissance survey, and space shuttle 240 to 350 for space experiment, and geostationary orbit 36,000 fixed point observation. This is the remote sensing platform. In spaceboard, remote sensing sensors are mounted on onboard a spacecraft or space shuttle or satellite orbiting the Earth. Spaceboard remote sensing provides the following advantages. First one, large area coverage, frequent and prospective coverage of an area of interest, quantitative measurement of ground feature using radiometrically calibrated sensor, semi-automated computerized processing and analysis, relatively low cost per unit per of coverage. Satellite images are generally lower resolution compared to the aerial photograph. However, very high resolution imagery is now comparably available in civilian user. These are the, there are two type of satellite, one is geosynchronous satellite and another one is sun synchronous satellite. The orbit which are same earth rotation means 24 hours 56 minutes per second in reside a day is called a earth synchronous orbit or geosynchronous orbit. The geosynchronous orbit is inclined is called 0 degree or geostationary orbit because the satellite look stationary of the equator from the ground surface view. The geostationary satellite is useful for covering the wide area. Many meteorological communication satellites are geostationary type. The typical case of geosynchronous bipolar, but polar orbiting satellite is myoclonus or molnia orbit during the long segment around the apogee. The satellite is visible for a very long period of time, can be taken advantage of communication purpose. These are the different type of satellite orbiting: equatorial, polar, near polar and geostationary. Then sun synchronous satellite. Most earth observation satellite, such as IRS, Landsat, etc. resolve the near polar orbit, which lower altitude these satellite orbit are sun-synchronous, such that they cover each area of the world at a constant local time. At any given altitude, the position of the sun is sky, as the satellite process overhead will be the same within the same region. This ensures consistent illumination condition when acquiring images. This is the important factor for monitoring changes between the images and mosaicing adjustment that they can have to correct the different illumination condition. This is the satellite, different type of, this is the geostationary satellite, and this is the polar satellite or sun synchronous satellite. This is the polar satellite example, and this is the geosynchronous or communication satellite. Thank you.